I did a video a while ago on vocal doubling. This is an effect that's super common in pop music, rap, and hard sell TV and radio ads. The effect sounds best when the person actually records the same thing twice, so you have two different tracks of the part you want doubled. Then, when you play them at the same time, it gives you that vocal doubling effect. Well, someone commented on that video last week asking why you couldn't just copy the first recording and then paste that into a second track and play those together, rather than having to record the same thing twice. When I explained the reason, he asked if I could make another video with that explanation, why just copying and pasting audio and playing them at the same time will not give you the vocal doubling effect. In the original video, I recorded a sample script for a fake hard sell radio or TV ad, so I'll just do that again here. Are you ready for this? Come on down this Sunday for some wild and crazy deals. Bring the whole family. Now, if I wanted to double that, I would do the best I could to record everything exactly the same as I did the first time. So let's see how well I can do. Are you ready for this? Come on down this Sunday for some wild and crazy deals. Bring the whole family. Okay, so I didn't do too bad. Are you ready for this? Come on down this Sunday for some... I got the timing off a little bit on this one, so let me see if I can correct that real quick. Come on down this Sunday for some wild and crazy deals. Bring the whole family. So obviously that's very different from just one recording. Are you ready for this? It's just one person saying something, and when you have two of that same person saying something, it sounds way different. Are you ready for this? Now let's try what the person who asked the question suggested and see what happens. I'm going to go ahead and mute track two and insert a new track. And I'm just going to copy all of this down to the track below it. There. So that person thought that this would have the same effect. Take a listen. Are you ready for this? Oh, didn't sound a whole lot different from just listening to one track. Let's listen to just the first track. Are you ready for this? And now let's add in the second track that I copied. Are you ready for this? It's just louder. So when they mix together, the volume increases, but that's the only effect that it has. Other than that, it still sounds like just one person. And the same thing is true if you try to create a stereo file out of this, because having two channels left and right that are exactly the same still sounds like it's coming from the center. Let's demonstrate that. I'm going to pan this all the way to the left, pan this one all the way to the right, and then play it. Are you ready for this? See, it still sounds like it's just coming from the center. That is why you can't make a stereo file just by doubling the left channel and making a left and right channel out of the same audio. It's the same concept here. The reason why you get the vocal doubling effect when you listen to the two that have been recorded separately, Are you ready for this? Is because it's impossible for a human being to duplicate exactly the same way that they recorded the first time. There are going to be timing and inflection differences. And the brain needs those differences to perceive that there are actually two sources of audio. And when you just copy and paste, there aren't enough differences. There are no differences. So the brain can't tell that there are two sources of audio. It just thinks there's one. But there is a way to trick the brain. If you really, really don't want to record the same thing twice, you can artificially create differences by offsetting one of those audios in time. So I'm going to right-click on this audio item and go to Item Properties. And at the bottom, I'm going to hit the Nudge/Set Items button. And I am going to nudge this position by 50 milliseconds to the right. So if I click nudge right, you see this stuff moves over by 50 milliseconds. Now let's take a listen. Are you ready for this? Now you get the vocal doubling effect, and it is the same recording. So let me undo that. Are you ready for this? Same recording doubled in exactly the same place and time. You get no effect. But nudge it 50 milliseconds to the right. Are you ready for this? Then you can create your own sort of fake doubling without having to record the same thing a second time.